Our state is facing staggering fiscal challenges, totally beyond what many taxpayers can comprehend. In fact, Moody's just today has said that our fiscal picture is so bad that we are the worst in the nation, even beyond and below California. So that's not a great thing going in. But today I've got in the controller's office more than 190,000 unpaid bills that are sitting on my desk, totals close to $4 billion. They date back now to April 19th, 2011. I'm just thrilled to death that we're paying bills from 2011 that we finally got out of 2010. And we don't have the money to pay it. I mean, it's just that's simple. I can only pay what Dan sends me and what the taxpayers are kicking in, and they're not buying. So the mountain of bills and money owed extends, from businesses, hospitals, schools, nonprofits, social service agencies, the very same people we count on in a bad economy to try and pick up some of the slack here. In fact, the state ended the fiscal year 2 months ago, roughly $7.3 billion in the red, if you factor in corporate tax refunds, corporate health insurance, interfund borrowing payments. And that number, by the way, is just about the same as it was in the last fiscal year. There really has been no improvement. So this adds to a continuation of the better part of 10 years without a balanced budget. Now, I know it balances out on paper, but that's as far as it goes. It is not a balanced budget. It has never been a balanced budget. There's too much off budget. There's too much gimmickry that hides this stuff, and it drives me crazy. That's what I can tell you. Now, you combine that with the current volatility of the markets and the fragile economy, then there's a serious potential of Illinois resulting in decreased revenues. People are not going out there and spending because businesses and individuals are not making that much. And they're also not hiring if the volatility is such that they don't know what's coming next. So along with an increased demand for services like Medicaid, we just can't afford it. The very thought that anyone would consider borrowing as a solution to our problem is breathtaking. We cannot use borrowing as a crutch for a tax system and a budgetary system that is just broken. So with more national credit downgrade, we now have to pay more to borrow, and clearly we can't afford to pay for that. I just ask that the legislature and our leaders here, I think, are very good on that front. Keep the budget as flat as possible. Don't add programs. Don't add spending. Don't borrow. Give me a chance to catch up so I can pay bills. That would be very, very nice. I'd appreciate it. More than ever now, I think we have the opportunity to fix these problems. I am optimistic about what we can do, and I think you're going to hear from our other state leaders with me today on some of the ideas that they have for this. Bottom line is we cannot keep spending more than we're bringing in. I mean, that should be common sense. Everyone needs to understand that. The public understands it, and everybody in government needs to understand that. I don't care if you call yourself Republican or Democrat, independent, vegetarian, whatever you are, all the way around. This is about the welfare of our state and our people, and these are the people we serve and are elected to serve. So we have to address our state's finances in a serious manner, and we have to do it immediately. This cannot be the old kick the can down the road routine. It has to get done. So if there's any chance of saving our economy, creating new jobs, getting the state back on track, the folks you see here are the ones who are going to try and do it, because the alternative is unimaginable at this point. So